Bishop Joseph Bambera, Bishop of the Diocese of Scranton. We're situated in the northeastern corner of the state of Pennsylvania. Welcome to our cathedral church, St. Peter's Cathedral here in Scranton. Behind me is a somewhat unusual painting, the painting that depicts the death of St. Joseph. That particular image is not rooted in some scripture passage. We just presume that Joseph passed away, was taken home to God, before Jesus began his public ministry. But what I find so encouraging about this picture behind me is that it clearly situates Joseph, Mary, and Jesus, the Holy Family, into the lived reality of our experience of life. They knew joy and sorrow. They knew struggling and pain. They knew death, grief, and countless opportunities that were given to them by God. Something that resonates with each one of us as we go through life, especially in these challenging times. The decision to celebrate a year dedicated to St. Joseph here in the Diocese of Scranton was an easy one. And the diocese, in addition to all sorts of personal devotions that individuals have to St. Joseph, probably two-thirds of the men in my family are named Joseph, myself included, we've been blessed in the diocese to have the presence of the Oblates of St. Joseph, who came to northeastern Pennsylvania over 100 years ago to minister to Italian immigrants. They have kept the flame of St. Joseph alive and well in our diocese and have invited individuals throughout the decades that they have been here to pray to him as a source of our hope in the midst of difficult times. Ironically, we began this particular year on the 19th of March, 2020. 3 days later, our church is closed during the first wave of the COVID health crisis. Many of the opportunities, many of the devotions, and many of the rituals that we had hoped would unfold in our parishes during the course of this year dedicated to St. Joseph simply did not. And yet, as I reflect upon this year, and as I reflect upon comments that faithful people from around our diocese have shared with me, the consensus was, it's been a very meaningful year to us. It didn't matter that we didn't have large events taking place. What really mattered was that we knew where to turn, and that St. Joseph, in his own quiet way, continued to respond to us in our needs, especially during this challenging time of the COVID health crisis. Brothers and sisters, how blessed we have been in the Diocese of Scranton to have this year dedicated to St. Joseph, and how pleased we are as we bring it to a close on March 19th to be able to embrace the year that Pope Francis has promulgated in his memory as well. And so, may we simply give thanks for the abiding presence of God. May we give thanks for the simple, quiet soul, St. Joseph, who gives us courage, hope, and a reason to move forward. I often reflect upon those words from St. Matthew's Gospel of the angel who spoke to Joseph in a dream. Do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife. I think St. Joseph speaks to all of us in the midst of the challenges that we are given. Do not be afraid. The Lord is with you. So, brothers and sisters, go to Joseph, who is our hope.